I've had several questions about reducing the amount of sky visible in video shot from the Phantom 3, so I decided to incorporate that into a larger discussion of improving waypoint planning with Litichi software. This video refines the planning process by considering POI and aircraft position and altitude, in addition to the field of view of the Phantom camera. While I use the Phantom 3, the concepts are applicable to shooting from any of the drones which have cameras with adjustable gimbal angles. While you can get quick waypoint missions and get quite good video without a lot of detailed planning, a little additional planning will enable you to fill the frame with your subject and reduce the amount of sky that can overwhelm your video. Using some diagrams, let's look at the details that you might want to address when planning a tight mission. The most overlooked detail is the field of view of the camera. The field of view is the frame you see in your video and images, but you can't control it as you can with cameras having a zoom lens. There are two formats for the field of view with Phantom 3. The still images have either a 4:3 format or a 16:9 format. The gold area of this image is the 4:3 photo format. The green area of this image is the 16:9 format for both photos and video. On the Phantom, the layout is always in landscape mode. The field of view vertically for video and for photos in 16:9 format is about 52 degrees. It is about 66 degrees for 4:3 stills. This image shows the angles for half the field, 26 degrees and 33 degrees. The horizontal field of view is about 82 degrees. The half angle is about 41 degrees in both photo and video mode. When using a point of interest, the center of the field of view is what points to the POI. When the POI and aircraft are at an altitude of about one-half the height of the subject, you need the aircraft at a distance of about 1.3 times the height of the subject to get the entire subject close to filling the height of the field frame. Here we have a tree about 80 feet tall, so we need about 1.3 times 80 for a distance to the tree of about 104 feet. This distance will make the tree large in the frame. Here is a simpler diagram that we'll use for flights. We still have the 80-foot tree, and the POI and aircraft altitude are at still 40 feet. We also have a person in the diagram, but not within the field of view of the camera. What can we tell about what the video might look like based on the diagram? First, since aircraft and POI are at the same altitude, the POI should be in the vertical center of the frame. Second, the area above the green line will contain mostly sky, and the area below the green line will contain the ground. Anytime the altitudes of the aircraft and POI are the same, the gimbal angle will be zero, and the line from the camera to the POI will be parallel to the horizon, and will divide the frame so the top half will be mostly horizon and above, and the bottom half will be the ground. Let's take a look at a flight based on this diagram. Notice that the tree is filling a good share of the frame. The POI is in the center of the tree and is in the center of the frame. The horizon is in the center of the frame. There is about an equal amount of sky and ground in the frame. If we increase the altitudes of the aircraft and POI, keeping the distance the same, we clip the bottom of the subject. Notice that the tree is now clipped at the bottom. Since the POI is at the 80-foot top of the tree, the top of the tree is now at the horizon. The horizon is still in the middle of the frame because the aircraft altitude and the POI altitude are equal. To get the bottom of the subject in the frame, we need to change the POI altitude to about 31 feet. With these settings, we not only get the bottom of the subject in the frame, but notice that the top line of the field of view is now parallel to the horizon. This means that you will still have some sky in your frame, but it will be much less than when the POI and aircraft were at the same altitude. If you're not using POI and you want to minimize the sky, set the gimbal angle to minus 26 degrees. The POI is now near the middle of the frame. The top of the tree is near the horizon. The sky takes up very little of the frame, since it is on the upper edge of the field of view. If we want the sky eliminated, we set the POI at 52 feet and increase the aircraft altitude to 120 feet. The gimbal angle goes to minus 33 degrees, and we see no sky in the image. Our POI at 52 feet is in the middle of the frame. The tree is entirely in the frame, and the sky is totally excluded from the frame. Our diagrams included a person. What do we have to do to get that person in the video frame? We raise the aircraft to 200 feet and set the POI altitude at minus 34 feet, producing a gimbal angle of minus 66 degrees. In this case, we use the POI just for forcing the gimbal to the correct angle, since there is nothing of interest at 34 feet below the ground, at least not in this video. The line of the POI would go through the frame about here on the sidewalk. The entire tree is in the frame, and the person is in the frame. The sky is still excluded, since the gimbal angle is lower than minus 30 degrees. Let's look at a manual flight to further see how gimbal angle and altitude affect the field of view.
Yeah, we want to fly over to the Keepy burner is about in the center of the screen now.
37 feet altitude, 1 feet distance, 0 miles per hour. Feet altitude, 101 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
Okay, notice right now we have the teepee burner about in the center of the screen. We have the aircraft probably about the same height as the teepee burner, and the horizon is about halfway down the frame.
52 feet altitude, 101 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
What we want to do is lower the camera angle a little bit at a time so we can see what happens. Okay, that's about 10 degrees down on the gimbal angle.
Notice 52 that feet altitude, 101 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
Notice that the horizon is getting closer to the top of the screen. Okay, we'll lower it another 10 degrees. So now the horizon is almost at the top of the screen. Those mountains in the background are pretty tall.
52 feet altitude, 101 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
The tree line is probably about equivalent to the horizon. We'll lower it another 10 degrees and notice that the horizon goes away altogether. Also, we're far enough away from the teepee burner that most of it is gone.
52 feet altitude, 100 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
But let's see what happens when we raise the altitude.
175 feet altitude, 100 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
We still have the camera down at the same angle as when we were at the lower altitude, but notice the horizon hasn't come back into the picture. We'll go up a little more.
208 feet altitude, 100 feet distance, 8 miles per hour.
So now we're over 300 feet, but the horizon still is out of the picture. Anytime you have the camera angled down at 30 degrees or more, you're not going to get any horizon. 309
feet altitude, 100 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
When shooting video with the gimbal angle at minus 30 degrees, you would have to climb to an altitude of more than 9 miles to get the horizon in view again.
We'll rotate the camera around the whole aircraft, and as you can see, no matter which way we rotate the aircraft, there's no horizon in the picture. To get the horizon back in the picture, we would have to tilt it.
101 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
We would have to tilt the camera back up, so I'll bring it back up 10 degrees. And notice that in the far distance, we can see almost to the horizon.
309 feet
altitude. Back up just a little bit more.
100 feet distance, 0 miles per hour.
Now the line right at the top is about where the horizon is. After that we have some more steep mountains, and those don't really represent the horizon from the ground.
Now that you've seen how field of view and altitudes of camera and waypoints affect the video framing, you probably want an easy way to do measurements. Fairly good ground measurements can be done with the Litichi app using waypoints. I'll add a waypoint to this area at the intersection of sidewalks. I'll then set the waypoint altitude to 11 feet. Now, I'll add another waypoint at the next sidewalk intersection and make sure its altitude is the same as the first waypoint. The distance of 123 feet between waypoints is shown on the segment connecting the two waypoints. If you want to mark the waypoints, just add points of interest to mark locations. You have to make a note of the distances, since there is no measurement between POIs nor between waypoints and POIs. Why did I make sure the altitudes for the waypoints were the same? It is because the distances between waypoints are for line of flight. If there is an altitude change, the distance between waypoints will be different. I'll raise the altitude of waypoint 2 to 130 feet. Notice that the distance has increased from 123 feet to 171 feet. If you use waypoints to measure, be sure that they are at the same altitude. How about using Litichi to help measure the height of a tree? Let's choose two waypoints to give the distance from the tree, making sure the altitudes are the same, 5 feet. The distance to the sidewalk intersection is about 288 feet. You can then get the angle to the top of the tree with your cell phone or other angle measuring device. Here, it is about 16 degrees. You can calculate the height of the tree by the formula height equals distance times the tangent of the angle using your cell phone calculator. Or you can use the height table I provided at montanamonk.com/heighttable.pdf. If angles or distances are between numbers, use the higher numbers to be sure you don't clip the subject. The table shows the tree to be about 83 feet high. I hope this video helps you make tighter flight plans and helps reduce the overpowering sky in your videos. Thank you for viewing.